Getting stitches can be an intimidating process if you haven't had them before, but they're an important part of helping our body heal. So I'm off to find out exactly how they work. I'm here today with somebody who knows a lot about stitches. Dr. Margle is an ER doctor. And doctor, the first step is when people come in and they have a cut or a wound, the first step is determining whether or not they need stitches, and then also how many.
The goals of wound closure is basically you want to make sure that you restore function, make sure that you're preventing an infection, and probably the biggest concern for people is that you want to make it look as close to the original form as it did prior to the injury. And as far as how many sutures, that's one of the most common questions you always get.
Right, everyone always wants to know if it's going to be a lot or just one or two.
You know, it's one of those things where I don't know until I get started.
Right.
So I put my first stitch or staple in, and then I see the way the rest of the wound looks, and then you make a determination. I'm just thinking about what technique am I going to do to make sure that I have the best possible appearance of the wound.
And stitches aren't the only material that you can use to close a wound. There are also staples and medical glue.
Wounds that would be a good candidate for this are wounds that are very straight, that are clean, that would be not very long, so probably less than 5 centimeters. It's something that has to be able to come together very well on its own. Staples are not something you're going to use on an area you want a good cosmetic outcome.
Okay.
Primarily in the emergency department, we use staples on the scalp, but it's kind of similar to skin glue, but for deeper, a little slightly more complicated wounds.
Okay. And this is a point when people are probably pretty nervous when they're coming in. If I'm the patient, what do you say to me to calm me down before we go into this?
You're going to feel a little pinch, and that pinch should go away. You inject the medication. After a few seconds, they really won't feel anything at all except this numb sensation in the area. After you get the wound numbed up, it's very important to make sure the wound is clean.
Okay.
So we typically will irrigate the wound out with a high pressure spray of either water or saline to clean out any bacteria or debris that's in there. And then before we get started, we also look at the wound too to make sure that we're not seeing any foreign bodies in there. Once the wound is clean and you're sure there's nothing in there, then it's time to go. It's very important to make sure it's not too tight.
Uh-huh.
You're not causing any lack of blood supply to tissue, and you sew this up.
Yeah, it's just like sewing.
Exactly.
And it's pretty quick. I mean,
to do
a few of those, it's quick and...
It is.
And not very much pain associated with that.
There should be really none at all.
So the bottom line is that people really shouldn't be anxious about getting stitches.
Typically an almost painless procedure.
Okay.
It's quick, you get the cosmetic appearance back, you get your function back, and then you could go about your life.
As if it never happened.
Exactly.
All right.
Exactly.
Thank you so much, doctor. And to learn more about other medical procedures, head to our website, livinghealthytv.com.